You're dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here. Hey, listen. Now we can ride out of here. We'll pick a direction. We won't look back. Come on.
No, Deacon. I can't.
Are they forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I didn't come here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Wait a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.
Deer crossing, you know, there was a time where that was a bad idea, and you know what? It still is.
Yeah.
smell a nest. Gotta be right here. There's an abode. Visitors sit there. That's gotta be it. No, I just gotta find some yeast. Kitchen, yeah. Well, that's gotta be in the kitchen. Oh, shit. Breakers. Had to be breakers. That couldn't be fucking easy, could it? Marauders, good. Yeah, wait for me, huh? Thank you.
That's the last of them.
Okay. Now where the hell is the yeast?
Got it.
Yeast. Here it is. Yes. I hope this is enough.
St. John to Lieutenant Whitaker, reporting in.
Deacon, Corporal St. John, yes.
I got the item on your requisition form, the yeast. There wasn't much.
I'm sure that whatever you have is gonna be fine.
So, just curious, why do you need...
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something. I gotta go. I'll talk to you when you bring it in. Whitaker out.
Okay. You're welcome. Here we go.
Those freakers feel anything, you know, before. Sad, happy.
God damn it.
Ma'am?
Would you stop doing that, please?
I'm sorry?
I know that things are strange, but I can't help that right now.
Well, I live in a barracks with a dozen militia assholes. Well, my wife lives in a private tent up on an officer's ridge. Nothing strange about that.
Deacon.
And the only time that I see her is when I'm done running one of her errands. Nothing strange about that either, ma'am.
My yeast, thank you.
Are you baking something? I mean, if you need an oven, I know where to find one.
No, I'm using it to create viral proteins that they trigger these antibodies. But of course, you are being sarcastic.
Bread, viral proteins, it's all the same to me.
Hey, wait a second. Here. Thank you.
You already said that.
I meant for staying.
Yes, ma'am.
no. Set them over there. Thank you. Corporal St. John, this is Dr. Jimenez. St. John?
Hey, Doc. This is Deacon. What can I do for you?
St. John, good. I need you to stop by the infirmary.
Is something wrong? You need something?
No, no. Nothing like that. I want to check on that arm.
My arm? My arm's fine, Doc.
A burn like that? From a wood stove? It's nothing to play around with. You want la infección? You come see me. That's an order.
All right, Doc. All right, fine. Whatever you say. St. John out.
So, man, I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
I knew you from before. Well, not personally, you know, but I'm from Farewell. Same as you. And me and my friends, we used to watch you guys around town. The mongrels, I mean. Riding those hogs, wearing your leathers. Man, we thought you guys were so badass.
Right. Is that right?
Yeah, man. Had a lot of free time on my hands. I had to drop out of high school, you know. Knocked up my girlfriend. Had to get a job. Hey, if you ever decide to, you know, start up an MC, mongrels, whatever, just count me in, okay? I'm down.
Yeah, don't hold your breath.
Sure, man. Yeah, no, just saying. Corporal, see you, man.
Oh, Corporal, what's happening?
Yeah, Captain, I'm here.
Well, I just wanted to let you know that the Colonel gives an informal talk every day at dusk at the staging area where you were sworn in.
Yes, sir.
Now, while these talks are informal, enlisted men and women are expected to attend.
Copy that, sir.
Hurry out.
Oh, great. A commander who likes to give fireside chats. Can't wait.
Corporal? All right. Take care.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Corporal.
Hey, Sarge.
These past few days, dozens of new recruits have joined our ranks. We welcome them. We do not care about the color of your skin. We do not care what country you were born in. We do not care if you are a man or a woman. We do not care if you are gay or lesbian or bisexual or transgender. These are things beyond your control. These are things that God has ordained, and we accept them. What we do not accept are liars, thieves, rapists, murderers, fornicators, adulterers, oath breakers, drug addicts, or criminals of any kind. From this life or the one before, how you conduct yourself, how you act in the eyes of God, these are things that you do control. Any soldier or officer found guilty of any transgression, no matter how small, will be brought here to this very scaffold and will be hanged by the neck until they are dead. This punishment may seem cruel to some of you, but you have my promise. Any punishment of ours is a great mercy compared to the punishment of God that is being unleashed on the world outside these walls. None of us is perfect. We do not expect perfection. What we do expect is obedience, order, and discipline. Give us these things, and we will win this war. Company dismissed.
Hey, Doc.
Come in. Siéntese. Have a seat. Have a seat.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Let's look here. So, who did you ride with back in the day?
I don't know what you're getting at.
No me mientas. Look, Corporal. I spent 20 years in East L.A. patching up bandas de motoristas and every other kind of pandillero. I know the look. And this? No kind of wood stove did this. All right. Keep it clean. It'll heal on its own. Leave a nasty scar. But I want you to come back and see me in a couple of days.
You got it.
Funny thing. When the city burned and the hordes came in, neighborhoods at war for decades all came together, fought together. Latinos, güeros, chinos, bloods, crips. Didn't matter. Crazy what it takes to bring people together sometimes, no?
Thanks, Doc.
St. John, come in. Taylor to Deacon St. John.
Taylor. Haven't heard from you in a while. I was afraid that maybe you'd gotten too close to that man you were tracking.
Oh, I'm close, all right. I'm right in their friggin' backyard. Hey, I need your help, man. I'm at a small camp south of Crater Lake, just off the South Rim Drive.
Taylor, listen to me. I have no idea what you're doing, but you got...
Oh, shit! No! Let me go! Hey!
Taylor? Taylor! Oh, damn it. St. John to Lieutenant Whitaker. Come back.
Switching to a private channel. Hold on. Deacon, are you there?
Yeah. Hey, so I looked at that requisition form. It says that you want silicate?
Yeah, silicate. I use it as a distilling medium in the column chromatographer.
What?
Sorry, it's the one part of my research that's actually going well.
So, silicate, where do I get it?
Oh shit, I thought I marked it on the rec. Hold on. Okay, there's this little general store southwest of us near Mazama Village. You should be able to find it there.
Okay, got it.
Thank you. Sorry, never mind. Carry on, Corporal.
Yes, ma'am. Lieutenant.
Sarah, out.
Silicate. What the fuck is silicate anyway?
Deacon, are you there? Deacon.
I'm here.
Look, I know we have a lot to talk about.
Ma'am?
This is a private channel. Deke?
Okay.
I want you to know that I meant what I said about you staying and helping. I know this can't be easy for you, being here like this.
Hey, where else am I gonna go? And if I leave, they're gonna make me get back this really cool hat, so I'm starting to like this hat. I mean, really.
I bet. Okay. All right, I gotta get back to work. This yeast has already filled up like half a dozen petri dishes.
Okay, save me some of the viral proteins. I got an appetite out here.
I'll do that. Lieutenant Whitaker out.
Thank you.
Captain Corey, this is Corporal Russell. Come in. Move back, damn it. Move!
You heard him. Pull back! Pull back!
Russell, report.
Sir, we were on a supply run trying to get the Shemolt, and we ran into the biggest goddamn horde you've ever seen.
Damn it! Move your asses! Come on! Move! You heard the Corporal!
Now, Corporal, listen to me very carefully. Get your men out of there. We are not ready to engage. Do you copy me?
Yes, sir. You don't gotta tell me twice. Russell out. Come on, move it! Let's go!
We're pulling out! Let's go! Go! Go!
Corporal St. John, are you there? I need you to report to me at command at your convenience.
Colonel, of course, sir. St. John out.
Come on, boy. Don't give up on us. Tell us where your camp is. Maybe we'll let you live. Fuck you.
Bring him down!
I don't think he can hear us.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can do something about that.
I'm not telling you shit.
Come on!
Let's do this.
Cut him!
Can you hear that? Get him the fuck out of here!
Come on!
What do you think? Maybe we could turn this in at that army camp and get some credits.
Jesus Christ.
I'm coming, Taylor. Hang in there.
That's the last of them. I just gotta find a way in. That did it.
Kill him. Kill him!
No, man! No, no!
Do it! Oh,
how you doing, Taylor?
You know, I've had better days, I'll be honest with you.
Okay. Jesus. Okay, listen to me, pal. Take this, hold it against your head like that. Good. No, I want you to wait here. I'm gonna go radio Captain Curry. He's gonna send someone to pick you up, all right?
All right, man. Yeah, hell yeah.
Captain Curry, this is Corporal St. John. Come back.
This is Curry. I'm here with Lieutenant Whitaker checking on your progress.
Corporal, I've told Captain Curry that you're an immense help. I don't know what I would do without you.
Oh, well, thank you. That's great. It's not why I'm checking in. Captain, there's a marauder camp just off of South Rim Drive.
Marauders? This close.
So, what were you saying?
Marauders? This close to the island?
No. I dealt with these bastards, but we have an injured man, Private Taylor. They fucking slice his ear off.
Jesus, is he all right?
Private Taylor? What was he doing out there?
He's gonna live. No idea what he was doing out here. I need you to send Captain Jimenez and some men to come out and get him. I'll send you the coordinates.
I'll head up there now and let him know. Curry out.
Grenade!
Taylor, how you doing, buddy?
Like I said, man, I've had better days. Hey, I think the bleeding stopped.
Oh.
No, It hasn't.
Okay. Help is on the way. You hang tight. You want me to come back and wait with you?
No. Oh, hell no. No. I mean, I already feel like a little bitch, you know? I'm fine. I'm fine, really.
I'll stop by the infirmary later. I'll see how you're doing.
Hey, I've seen that thing. It's pretty cushy. Way better than being out here, let me tell you.
Yeah, I've seen it too. Don't give the doc too much trouble. You got that? Deacon out.
Let's go.
Catch!
There's another one. Time to burn. Newts. Wonder if they got anything in their nest. Another micro recorder. Yeah, that must have been a clearance sale on these things, the way that Nero keeps leaving them around. Yeah, a Nero injector. Let's see if it still works. This will help me focus.
2069. Following up on a couple of reports that my supervisor kicked over to me from the SAT surveillance team, militia patrols have been spotted on 8 different occasions at this location. Which wouldn't be remarkable, except they haven't burned it to the ground. So, anyway, that got the attention of my supervisor. Turns out he was right to flag this. Designated Site 307, a 1950s-era vacation house, has become a nest for a group of infected adolescents. Approximately 8 to 12 individuals, depending on migration patterns. Results from blood tests run on 2 males, approximately 13 and 11 years of age, show antibodies and antiviral proteins that, frankly, we can't identify. The lab's going to get back to me. Conclusion? Someone in the militia is running experiments on these little guys. Who would be doing that? And why?
Her name is Sarah. And, why? Well, because she's trying to wipe the little shits out, and I'm gonna help her. This'll happen. This looks like the spot. Let's go find some silicate.